just to help us understand this, I want to actually also emphasize that let's find these types of changes in an image, a real image like this one, of course, the Tech Tower, photo taken by my colleague Henrik Christensen. And let's look at various types of things within this image. First, let's look at illumination changes. Now, if you look at this scene, there is, of course, because of lighting changes, there is shadows. Those are illumination changes. You can, of course, see a lot of different types of things. There's not a lot of specular reflection here, but that kind of tells us that there could be some changes happening in the scene because of that. If the lights were on, we would actually see a lot more illumination information. We can separate out things like the word tech because the color is different in front of that. Also, it has a specific shape that actually helps us also distinguish and separate that out. Depth discontinuity again comes in. This tower here is in front of something else. We can look at that depth and see that this has to be in front, so there should be some sort of a discontinuity here at the tower. Surface normal. Basically, again, if you look at the steps here, you can see a lot of discontinuities because sometimes the surface normals at these steps are changing around. You can see those kinds of things across in the shape here. Each one of the shape basically has a different surface normal, and it helps us kind of distinguish that. Of course, objects have well-defined boundaries. This, fire flume kinds of things here, or the roof decks here have different objects, the windows and such. Each one of them have different levels of detail, and again, that could be, of course, looked for separately. And of course, also additionally, reflectance change. Now, this is most visible here because when I go down this rooftop, you can see the changes in colors. A much more subtle change, but there is definitely a reflectance change here that starts telling me that this is a different shape. And of course, there's, of course, more changes in this one too. Hopefully this helps you try to start thinking about how we can actually look for these types of changes in real images.